Hello everyone, I'm Santiago Santiago, and today I'm gonna be testing Red Dead Redemption 2 on the GTX 1050 Ti. To skip to any of the resolutions tested, check the timestamps down in the description. So the game only has TX11 or Vulkan. By default the game launches on the Vulkan API. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to use TX12, the game just crashes on startup. I'll talk more about later in the video. Some people were seeing that DX12 was having less stutters than Vulkan. Basically, Vulkan gives us higher FPS, but a lot more stutter. That's what I could gather from other videos. So in the options menu, we have a ton of options. The ones that affect the performance the most for me were global illumination, reflection quality, near and far volumetric resolution, volumetric lighting, full resolution screen space ambient occlusion, water reflection, grass level of detail, geometry level of detail, particle quality, and after lowering those I mentioned together, if that's not enough, just lower the other options I didn't mention in groups. That should help you out to tweak the game. Avoid shadows and reflections on ultra, lower those to high to get a good performance improvement. And there's an option called water physics. When you keep it on the maximum, it gives you like half the frame rate in some cards. I recommend keeping that on 50% or 75%. At the moment. And on the texture and particle quality options, if you change any of those two, it will require to restart the game. Some of the basic options affect the advanced ones, such as water quality and volumetrics quality. If you edit any of those two, that will affect the advanced options, so keep that in mind. You'll see that those two that I mentioned will say instead of low, medium, or high, just custom. For the testing, I just ran into St. Denis, one of the big cities of the game. I remember on PS4 that I had a lot of FPS drops there, and basically there's higher CPU usage in that city compared to just being in the wilderness. There's also a lot of NPCs, a lot of effects, a lot of buildings, there's grass, there's trees, there's pretty much everything in there. In comparison to the first 5 minutes of the game, it runs slightly better, but keep in mind that the first 5 minutes of the game are super effect heavy, and I couldn't find any other place where the game ran that bad, so consider this to be more in line with the rest of the game. Just suffer for the first 5 to 10 minutes of the campaign, then the frame rate will just stabilize. Then on the CPU side of things, while a quad-core CPU didn't get maxed out most of the time, there were tons of frequent stutters. And those stutters run like for 5 seconds in some cases, which is super annoying. In those cases, the CPU spikes to 100%, then goes back down to where it was before. Some people on the internet tried using a program that limits the game's CPU usage to around 90%. So if you want to try that out, follow the link down in the description to the Reddit tutorial. Other than that, if you want to avoid those stutters, make sure to have a CPU with more than 4 threads, something like a 6-core i5 or Ryzen 5. That doesn't completely get rid of those stutters, but it makes it significantly less frequent. Then on the system RAM, try to have more than 8GB on dual channel. If you only have 8GB, I recommend you use DX12 on the Nvidia cards and Vulkan on the AMD GPUs. That usually made me stay below 8GB most of the time, but since I cannot test DX12 right now and can only use a Vulkan, on the Nvidia cards I saw more than 8GB of usage. And it was pretty easy to get over 8 gigs, so keep that in mind. And finally, there are tons of issues being listed on the internet. Thousands of users are having problems with this game. The ones I ran into were the game not launching on my Ryzen 5 PC. It seems that the 3000 series CPUs from AMD required the latest microcode. I think it was 1.0.0.4. Unfortunately, my motherboard doesn't have that one yet, so I cannot launch the game. Then, I couldn't launch the game on DX12 no matter what I tried, so I had to edit a config file in order to enable Vulkan and get back into the game. And as you will see in many of my videos, that there's a cursor at all times present on the gameplay. It sometimes went away, sometimes it went back in. It's something I couldn't control. Some people said that updating Windows helped. I tried that and it helped for like a couple hours, then it went back into the screen. So hopefully all the issues that are plaguing this game are resolved as soon as possible. In the meantime, I recommend you don't pay for this game, it's just a lottery to get the game to work, apparently. So you're probably lucky if you're having no problems with this game at the moment. So if you want to play this game, just wait for the fixes, and then if everything is fine, spend the money on the product. But at the moment, I highly do not recommend it. So yeah guys, that's about it. I hope you keep enjoying the video. Thanks for watching and see you next time.
There he is! No! away. You damn lunatic.
I'm gonna f- ah! You messed with the wrong